exorcism prayer, okay? Not because you are possessed or anything, not okay. But we have to do it because we are about to anointing you with the first oil, okay? This oil will give you a special power, okay? So that will help you to become like a superwoman, okay? So you're going to be able to fight against the temptation of the evil, okay, with this oil. Almighty and ever-living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan, the spirit of evil, to rescue man from the kingdom of darkness and bring him into the splendor of your kingdom of light. We pray for this child. Set her free from original sin. Make her temple of your glory. And send your Holy Spirit to dwell within her. We ask this to Christ our Lord. May you have strength and the power of Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Dear community, please stand. Parents and godparents and dear Christian community, you have come here to present this child for baptism. By waters and the Holy Spirit, she is to receive the gift of new life from God who is love. On your part, you must make it your constant care to bring her up in the practice of the faith. See that the divine life which God has given her is kept safe from the poison of sin to grow always stronger in her heart. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew now the vows of your own baptism. Reject sin, profess your faith in Christ Jesus. This is the faith of the church. This is the faith in which this child is about to be baptized. For this reason, parents and godparents, dear Christian community, I ask you, do you reject Satan? In all his works, in all his empty promises, do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, was buried, rose from the dead, and he is now sitting at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body in life everlasting? This is our faith, this is the faith of the church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Parents and godparents, it is your will that this child shall be baptized in the faith of the church, which we have all professed with you. Anaí.
Hold on, make a sound of sure.
Okay. Anaí, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Smell like a perfume, okay? And it is composed of 60 different spices, okay? In the old times, it used to be used to anointing the kings, the prophets, and the priests. And the church, we use it for your baptism, and later on, when you get confirmed, for us priests, when we get ordained, and for all the new bishops, okay? He will give you three special gifts. You will be priests, not like me, but a loyal priest. Okay. So when you grow up a little bit more, and you have more conscience, you're going to be praying to God and for your own sacrifices and prayers before the Lord. You're going to be a prophet, because you will have to give testimony of God in your life, with your friends, with your family, and you're going to be a queen, okay? Because God himself is king, and now you are a daughter of God, okay? Very good. God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has freed you from sin, give you a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and welcome you into his holy people. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation, as Christ was anointing priests, prophet, and king. So may you live always as member of his body, sharing everlasting life. So now you want to light the candle from the Easter candle all the way up there. You are told that you may have to go around through the stairs. You can do it from there. So now the four of you hold the candle without the burning. Receive the light, O Christ. Prayers and grandparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. These children of yours have been enlightened by Christ. She is to walk always as children of the light. May she keep the flame of faith alive in her heart. When the Lord comes, may she go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. We all say amen. Amen. Okay. But it was light. So you guys know. I'm going to touch your ears and your lips, okay, with the word epitha. That means be open, okay? Epitha. The Lord Jesus, who made the bed here and the dumb speak, may soon touch your ears to receive his word, in your mouth to proclaim his faith, to the praise and glory of God the Father. We'll say amen. Amen. That's okay. It's not. You don't even. Thank you. So you are too heavy, so I won't knock you. So just come with me. So, dear Christian community, I'm proud to present to you this new Christian. Congratulations, Anaí. Are you happy now? Yes.